Here's how you piss off every single NFL fan. You do this. The New England Patriots, via Tom Pelissero of the NFL Network, traded a fifth-round pick in 2019. Conditional Browns pick would send back a seventh-rounder originally from the Kansas City Chiefs. What does that mean exactly? Who did they trade for? Ian Rappaport tells you. Josh Gordon, who had an MRI on his hamstring, I'm told it came out fine. That means Gordon could play for New England in week three. If we do remember, Mary Kay Cabot of Cleveland.com put out a report. I believe this was on Sunday. And she said, well, he was limping in practice and it was a hamstring injury, but apparently his hamstring is now fine. Whatever happened to that story, I don't know. Tom Brady went on the record. I'm going to do what I have done the last couple of weeks and just try to work with whoever is there, see if they can come in, make an impact, make a role on this team. It is really up to the individual what kind of role they can carve out for themselves. That is kind of how I feel. Josh Gordon, if we do, does he want to react to that?
That just wasn't really a glowing endorsement.
It was not a glowing endorsement. Not at all. I mean, like Stephen A. Smith put it perfectly. Like, I'm not trying to be rude here, but like, we're talking about someone who has an addiction. That's just what it is. Like cough syrup and look, we're all on the same page. Marijuana should be legal, especially for NFL players. They had a rule in place. The NFL still stupidly has a rule in place. He violated it many times. If we do remember in 2013, that is the season that we all point to with Josh Gordon. And here's, by the way, a simulation of what it might look like when they're scoring on your team every single Sunday, or at least the New York Jets. So Josh Gordon in 2013 had an incredible season with horrible quarterbacks. He had Jason Campbell, Brian Hoyer, and Brandon Whedon, and he still led the NFL in receiving yards. Was it smoke screens? Was it smoke and mirrors, excuse me? Smoke screens is what he will probably do with the New England Patriots. So who is who they have right now? Josh Gordon, Rob Gronkowski, Chris Hogan, Philip Dorsett, James White, and Cordero Patterson, formerly of the Minnesota Vikings. Good fit in your eyes or no?
A lot depends. I think, you know, we talk 2013, that's 5 years ago.
Yeah.
I think a lot of times when we do something special in life, we hold on to it forever. Like, hey, remember that time I did this? Well, that was 8 years ago. Mm-hmm. Like, you have to talk about what has he done lately. He hasn't done that in 5 years. He's barely been on the field. I saw some Randy Moss comparisons. That's insane. Yeah. You know, Randy Moss was, you know, an active player. Yeah, he had a down year with the Raiders and still, you know, caught 1,000
yards. I don't think it was, no. I don't think it was comparing Josh Gordon's skill set to Randy Moss's skill set.
Calling him the Randy Moss 2.0.
No, I disagree with that completely. I don't know who put that out. I thought of it more of, this is a guy who has character issues, who we all know is talented at the wide receiver position. The Patriots bring in broken birds, and then they literally flock their wings and fly away.
Yeah, but see, sometimes,
that's how I viewed it.
I think that's overrated with the Patriots. The Patriots have had their fair share of players that weren't quite right, and it didn't work out. They brought in a
wide receiver.
Yeah, they brought in a wide receiver last year. The one that was he was with the Cardinals and he had some issues with DUIs, Mike Floyd.
Just signed with Washington.
So I think we remember Randy Moss just like that was 5, 6, 7 years ago, but we don't remember all of the bad ones that happened. I think it's always going to be on Josh Gordon. Talent is always there. There's a lot of talented people out there. It's where is Josh Gordon mentally when he comes in there? Now, if you had all that rope in Cleveland, and they've waited a very long time for him to get his act together. You're coming in to the Patriots and Bill Belichick, and you're going to snap your fingers, and all of a sudden you're going to stand in line? That either, A, tells me he didn't have a lot of respect for the Browns, or B, it's not going to be an overnight type of thing where he's going to go out there and catch 8 passes for 150 yards and 2 touchdowns like nothing ever happened.
Right.
I lean toward not necessarily good or bad fit that the expectations are a little bit too high.
Mm-hmm.
I agree. I think the expectations are a little too high, but I do think that he is going to come in a lot hungrier than when he was with Cleveland, in the sense that it's kind of like when you're in a relationship, right? You're in a relationship with someone that you were with for, let's just say, 5 years. You're with this person for 5 years, right? And then everything's kind of just bland. It's not bad, it's just bland. And then you break things off, and you meet somebody else, and you're the best version of yourself that you've ever been. So 2013 might have been, he's pretty good, because actually a little more than good. But I feel this coming season, we might see that whole like, this is what you had in you this entire time. And it takes a new relationship for us to, you know, see this new side. So I do think the expectations are high, but I do feel like they're high for a reason, because, you know, there's excitement. He's not a terrible player. he just not hasn't been as consistent. You guys seen, this might be it.
Sorry, you guys seen Last Chance U on Netflix? Yeah. Mm-hmm. This is his last chance.
You think so?
Yes.
Think this is it?
You fail with the Patriots? Mm-hmm. Like, you pull like a Chad Ochocinco when you register like 8 snaps in a season? Mm-hmm. Done.
You look good at practice.
Done.
The first practice.
Who's that?
Josh Gordon.
Oh, Josh Gordon. Whenever he's on the field, he looks great.
He's just never on
the field. Just, yeah, it's just between the ears. Yeah. Like, yeah. I think that he has the skill set to be a great football player. Mm-hmm. I think we all agree on that. I don't know about, like, Skip Bayless with Hall of Fame worthy or anything like that for the hot take syndromes that unfortunately plague sports media. But it's more so Josh Gordon is an incredible wide receiver. He can be star worthy. Mm-hmm. He is a number one receiver when he has his head on straight. Mm-hmm. This is where you go when you need your head on straight. So if he can't do it here, done. I do not see another team. If he plays 5 snaps the rest of the season, or he gets cut in 3 weeks, who's going to take a chance on this guy? Why would you take a chance on this guy? You're setting yourself for unrealistic expectations, and you're just going to fall flat on your face and make an ass out of your own franchise.
And that's what I think the whole 2000, everybody see the spark of 2013 of if he's right on our team or our situation, this is what we could have. Because who doesn't want a 1,700-yard receiver? It's just at what point do you realize, you know, that's just never happened again. You hit 3 home runs in one game, and you know, but you strike out now all the time. Like, well, he hit those 3 home runs that one time. We just got to let him keep swinging. Eventually, you got to take him out of the lineup, you know, even though you may be paying him like Chris Davis. But I think, like you said, I don't know necessarily if this is his last stop, but I think if he doesn't succeed in this stop, then what you're going to have is basically journeyman status. And people are going to say, you know something? That was 2013, and that's just never happened again. Honestly, life-wise, I think is the most important thing, you know, for him. If he can just be, forget the 1,700 yards. If he can just be in a stable for a year, just a stable a year or two, a stable environment in the NFL, that helps get his life together. So because what we don't want is him to get cut again or something, and then it spirals out of control.
All right. Josh Gordon to the Patriots. Good fit, bad fit. Comment section below. Subscribe to TYT Sports. Do you guys want full TYT episodes?
Yeah!
So download YouTube TV and get a 7-day free week trial.